When grilling shrimp, what size is best? Should you skewer them? Should you leave the shells on or off? Does marinating actually improve the flavour? And are there any things we can do to help them brown up without overcooking them? Let's find out. So today we're putting something like 13 variations of grilled shrimp to the test, and whatever wins, I'll put in the description below as the winning recipe. First though, let's touch on what it is we're after when grilling shrimp. So it's quite simple. We want two things. We want a really nice char on the shrimp, but we also want to make sure the meat is flavorful and tender and juicy. We don't want to overcook it. So I'm dividing this test into two rounds. First, we're going to look at the size of the shrimp and the method of cooking. So we've got a few varieties of shrimp that we'll cook. We'll also test cooking over a plancha, directly over the coals, in their shells, out of the shells, on skewers. And then the second round, we're going to look more at what we can do to elevate the browning and the flavor. So we'll look at things like marinades, vinaigrettes, brining, adding baking soda, to see what gives us the best result when grilling shrimp. First though, let's prepare our shrimp. So I've prepped our shrimp for the first round by thawing these under running water. I then deveined them just by cutting a slit in the belly and hooking out the intestine with a knife, because no one really wants to be eating that. I then patted them dry with some paper towel and popped them in the fridge for about 20, 30 minutes. It's just gonna help dry out any surface moisture, which will help us get a really nice char. So let's talk through our six contenders. So first up, we got tiger shrimp in the shell. These exoskeletons have so much flavor, and it's also gonna help protect that delicate meat from the high temperatures. Next up, we have exactly the same shelled. Third, same again, but butterflied. I have a feeling this has a risk of overcooking just because there's nothing really protecting that delicate meat. But it is quite a popular way to do barbecue shrimp, and if nothing else, it looks quite nice. Then over here, we've got our king prawns, firstly on a skewer. So the advantage of using a skewer, other than being easier to handle, is that by nesting them like this, so they're kind of spooning each other, we're reducing the surface area of each individual prawn, which means we can cook these for about an extra 30 to 60 seconds without them overcooking. And that could be the difference between them getting a nice char and no char. Then these two, I'm gonna cook on a plancha on the gas grill, and these I'm gonna cook directly over the charcoal.
All right, got full chimney. So I'm gonna go for a two-zone setup and just stack this really high on one side because we want to get as much heat as we possibly can. I'm also going to pop a few hickory chunks. I'm gonna try and bury them as much as I can just so they get really nice and hot. We do get some good flavor. If I had pecan, I would probably be using pecan right now. So I'm going for hickory because hickory's got quite a strong wood smoke. And because we're gonna be growing these for such a short space of time, we can kind of afford to go for something pretty smoky.
Good to go. All right, time to taste these and see which one's best. So I'm gonna start with the tiger prawn that was shelled. Not bad, but I think that was cooked a little bit too long to get the char on that. Not super juicy, that is a little bit overcooked. So let's see how the tiger prawn did that was cooked in its shell. We'll see if that's any better. Much juicier. But nowhere near, it doesn't have any of that like nice charred flavor. Yeah, that's a shame. That's really nice and juicy, but it just doesn't have any kind of char. You can sort of see like there's no, I'm not getting any of like the smoky taste on it or, yeah. It's a shame, kind of halfway between those two. You kind of want the char on the last one, but how juicy that one is. So next I'm gonna try my butterfly shrimp. So this one kind of like curled up a little bit. I think probably what I do next time is maybe pressing it a little bit when it goes on, or maybe making a few slits just so as that as the meat kind of tightens and contracts, it doesn't kind of make a weird shape. Let's see how it tastes. Okay. That's surprisingly juicy actually, and a good amount of flavor. I didn't think that'd be as nice as the other ones, but I think so far that's my favorite. So next I'm gonna try the prawns that were skewered. I'm gonna start by tasting one that was in the middle. It'll have been shielded by the ones around it. So let's see. I think that's the winner so far. So in terms of the king prawns versus tiger prawns, I think this might be a lot nicer. Okay, so next we're gonna go the king prawns that were cooked directly over the hot coals. starting to dry out a little bit. So you can see it's just starting to kind of like shrivel up a little bit. It's clearly like starting to dry out. So far I'm gonna say the winner is the skewered prawns. So lastly, we've got the king prawns that were cooked on the plancha on the gas grill. Between that and the skewer's definitely nicer. Very, very subtle amount of smoke, but that just that kind of taste of charcoal, definitely a winner. So out of all these, I'm gonna say the skewered king prawns are the winner. So in that first round, I intentionally didn't want to add much flavor because I wanted to make sure that the difference I was tasting was the difference between the cooking methods and the type of shrimp. In this next round though, we're testing different marinades, vinaigrettes, and brining methods. I'll put all the recipes in the description below, but we're keeping it really simple, really classic with lemon, garlic, and chili. And what we're looking for is to see which one tastes the best. First though, we need to get our grill nice and hot. So we've got 7 contenders. We have 3 different salt brines. One contains just salt, another contains baking soda, and the third contains sugar. We're gonna put all 3 shrimp in the fridge for about 20 minutes on a wire rack tray. We then have some shrimp that's gonna soak in a marinade of olive oil, lemon zest, lemon juice, garlic, chili, salt, and pepper for about 20 minutes in the fridge. And I've also made up a vinaigrette that's very similar but has a higher ratio of lemon juice and white wine vinegar. And we're gonna dip our shrimp in this after they're cooked to see how this compares to pre-marinating. Lastly, we'll test 1 shrimp with marinade and vinaigrette and 1 with none of the above as a control. All right, it's the same as before. I've got a full chimney of lit lump wood. I'm gonna drop in a couple of bits of hickory and then we're gonna do a 2-zone setup. So we get as much heat as we can on one side. I can smell that hickory, it smells great. Get nice and hot. Let's get a lemon on there. So first we're gonna go on with our brined prawns, with the baking soda and the sugar. Then we're gonna go on with the marinade. I'm just gonna move some bits around. These lemons are getting in the way. Need a bigger grill. It's my problem. It's everyone's problem. We all need bigger grills. Right. All right, now we wait and see. All right, time to give them a taste. So before I do, I can see that visually, the shrimp that we brined and coated in the sugar and baking soda seem to have got the best char. Not a huge amount. I think next time I would probably put the grates a little bit closer to the coals just to encourage them to char a bit more, but they have got the most color on them. So first I'm gonna try this is the one that just had the salt brine. So this was in the fridge for about 20 minutes. That's really good. Big, big improvement on the ones that we did earlier that didn't have any brine. Okay, so this one's got baking soda. Frankly, I don't think this is gonna be any better because the point of the baking soda would be to help it crisp and it hasn't really helped it too much, so. Yeah, same as that one, really. Not really any different. This one does look a bit different. The sugar has just started to caramelize in some places. We'll see what this is like. Obviously, it's also gonna affect the flavor as well. Yeah, big winner. That's much, much better. Okay, so next we're gonna taste the ones that we pre-marinated in the fridge for 20 minutes in the lemon and garlic marinade. All right. Yeah, pretty good, but that's got nothing on the one that just had the sugar and salt on it. It's nice. It's nice to have a bit of that flavor, but saying that is pretty good. Next I'm gonna test one that's been in the marinade. I'm gonna dip it in the vinaigrette. That's the winner by far. That's really, really good. It's a lot more complex than the others because you can sort of taste the first kind of bite, you get that sharpness from the vinaigrette. You then sort of get some of the flavors from the marinade. And there's a bit of that kind of wood smoke. That's really nice. All right, so these ones haven't been marinated. This has just been in the fridge for a bit. So I'm gonna try this just with the vinaigrette on its own. See if it's just as nice or, I don't imagine it'd be better, but we'll see. Really nice, but it's not as kind of, it's not as complex as the last one. Like you kind of just get the flavor of the vinaigrette and then the flavor of the prawn. It is really nice though. I definitely prefer those flavors in a vinaigrette. I think things like the garlic in particular Having it as kind of fresh garlic and the lemon zest, you taste a lot more in the vinaigrette compared to in the marinade. But I think combining both of them is just really good. I've not actually done that before, and that's really nice. So I'm just gonna test one that's not got anything on at all, just to see where this lands. Nope. Wow, okay. I'm kind of glad I did do that, because that shows just how much flavor all of these methods are adding. This tastes so remarkably dull, and like there's so little flavor other than the, you know, kind of prawn taste that you expect. But all of these are just so next level compared to that. I didn't expect it to be quite such a big difference, but let's go in with the vinaigrette again. I massively rate this vinaigrette. This is really simple, but so flavorful. I could do this all day. Right. So next time I'm grilling shrimp, I'm absolutely using skewers. I think that did a really good job of keeping them nice and juicy and tender and just easier to handle. One thing I would do differently is lower them closer to the coals just to encourage them to get a bit more char. But I'm absolutely going to be making a vinaigrette in the future. I think that added so much freshness to the flavor, and in combination with the marinade, it just worked really, really well. I would not brine again. I don't think that adds enough of an enhancement to the flavor to make it worth doing. Plus, you could just add a bit of salt or a bit of sugar into your marinade if you wanted to kind of encourage the sugars to caramelize or the salt to kind of brine it a little bit. But all in all, these were pretty good. There are a few things I do differently, including playing around with the marinade. In fact, there's one in this video where I tested scallops with, I think, 5 or 6 different marinades. And there's one in that, I think, the honey pimenton one, which I think would work really well on this. So if you enjoyed this experiment, remember to subscribe to the channel and click on the screen, and I'll see you in the next experiment.